Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will explain you how to do a fine tuning of a LLM for document summarization. Essentially, I will take a T5. I did in few words several tests with different versions of T5, the derivative models, and with different data sets. And well, I will explain you the whole process. I'm developing this component, a part of a bigger pipeline, and then I will do a second video where I explain all this document classification pipeline, where the document summarization is just a component which help me to do the final classification. Well, let's move to the origin. Document summarization, as you probably know, is just create a shorter version of the document, of a document or a text, that is the input. And then there is two types of this is a sequence to sequence tags. You need to use specific classes from transformers to do this task, and you also can only do it with specific models in specific architectures. We will look at this in few seconds. So there is two kinds of summarization: extracted, which essentially is kind of the get the most relevant keywords that represent the document, and abstracted. In the first case, in extracted, you don't generate a new text. It's just essentially taking the most representative keywords or keywords from the document and extract it, with this generates a new text which summarize or take the or capture the meaning and the sense of the document, and is done in such way that is shorter than the original text. You have a reference here. I'm putting you is the original tutorial from Hugging Face, from where I take the how to say all the ideas to make this tutorial and to fine tune this model. Also, there is a different data sets. Some of them are specialized in extractive summarization, some of them in abstracted summarization. I made a test with three of them. Would say four, but one of them even I didn't comment in the initial one I use is what the data set they use here in the document. I think I have it here, but that is quite a specific data set related to financial documents from California State. I finally, after doing the initial test, I decided to find a more suitable data set to do this fine tuning. Probably for in other use case is the appropriate. I think that they just use it to show how to build a pipeline to fine tune a summarization an LLM for a summarization task. But in my case or in my specific use case it didn't work. The same that the for example, PubMed summarization dataset, which is an abstracted dataset, it didn't give me the outputs that convinced me too much, and finally I decided to use the Multinews. Multinews is abstracted. This is prepared for abstracted summarization, and also Samsung. Why I choose Multinews? Because it's bigger. It has, you will see, Samsung is. It's not, well, it's a small data set with around about 15,000 texts with a very small data set for test and validation. And again, finally, I decided to use the Multinews because it's bigger, it's practically 50,000 different samples and also important done by the summarizations are done by professionals. So you see here to the car of the data set, you can take a look how the documents and the summaries are done, and they explain on their on the on the information of the data set. The summaries are done by professionals, so this is, well, a sign of at least of the quality, no? When later you are going to do the evaluation, well, it's first of all we come with something that you probably can rely on or can trust, that the summarization was done in order to understand if the summarization was correctly done. Okay, so what more? This kind of an open discussion here, extracted as well at the time of evaluate your output. So we are using roads, and well, I think that it's very difficult to compare, how to say, the same fine tuning done with an extractive or an abstracted data set ready for, no? And then why? Because you think extracted, what is extracted summarization and how the roads metrics works, probably you are going to get much better metrics or much better performance using an extracted data set. And also it's gonna be easier manually, for example, testing some examples, it to check if the summarization, in your opinion, was correctly done. No, abstracted, in the other hand, is a little bit more complicated because you are generating the new text, and generating new text, which how to say, capture the most relevant information of the original text, is a little bit more complicated to evaluate, at least in my opinion, because, well, you need to know very well the meaning of the sentence, and especially when you are not mastering the languages. Because, well, in English, for example, I'm not, English is not my mother tongue, and then probably I don't capture completely the sense of some specific sentence, especially when you are speaking in this case it is news, or in the case they put methods is medical publications, no? So, and then you need to master very well the language, even being a kind of linguistic person who knows very well the language in order to evaluate correctly the summaries. And then that's why also I decide to use an extracted data set, because just a first eye, no, to manually taking some predictions, you can evaluate easily that if the extraction, if the summary is more close or is better than the extraction that is done within in an abstracted data set, no? And then, well, my opinion is that also, again, I think for the test I did, the metrics using rows were bigger, or yeah, in using the extracted data set rather than the using the abstracted. And it's obvious because, well, in one case you focus in taking I will say the keywords, no, that represent the text, and in the other you are generating new text. And again, understanding how the roads metric is working, this is evaluating the test versus n grand, 1 grand, 2 grands, etc., and the longest sequence present in the input and output. If you understand that, if you have an abstracted data set, is even I will say that even rows is not the right metrics to analyze that. But again, an open discussion as well, that there is a lot of research around that, how to evaluate correctly this. Rose is not perfect, but in my opinion, it's making even more complicated when you use an abstracted dataset rather than to use an extracted one. Okay, let's start. I just I make also sorry some reference to the dataset I tested in during this experiment, and then I will pass you not only this dataset that is the, sorry this notebook that is the latest one. I have some other tests with other with the other datasets, and also doing LoRa optimization and using other versions of the T5, the other T5 derivatives and size models in those notebooks. And then finally, I decided as well to take one of the smallest ones, just to, well, because later, as again, this is going to be a component of a bigger pipeline. I don't want to have a huge model, because it's a component part of the a process, and you will see understand as well that the summarization is an activity that demands a lot of resources, and then better to use a small model, personalized or fine-tuning, and then don't introduce additional delays just because you want to get a 1% more in the metrics. That again, they are not perfect, and in some cases are even difficult to evaluate what even evaluate the output. Oh, come on, crash. Okay, so we install the libraries that we need. We mount in this case the my drive here. Another note here: not all the architecture, I think I said this at the beginning, can be used for document summarization. Had to be some models that are ready to do sequence to sequence training. So in the notebook, in the documentation of Hugging Face, they told you which architecture you can use with this for this activity. And then again, I made testing with the long T5, with the N5, and with the T5 derivatives. And then finally, I took a flantified base, and this is the model that I'm going to use finally to develop the this component. Import the libraries I need, creating the context in Google Colab, login in OneDB as usual, weight and biases, device CUDA. I'm using here a A100 for the training. Even this model being small, 250 million parameters, the dataset is also not extraordinarily big. You can see here is practically 55,000 samples. For training, we use only use 50,000 approximately. Yeah, but if you use a T4, it's gonna take approximately what the bar information bar told me. This runs about 56 hours. I finally did it, the training with the A100. That is a little bit expensive. But the training took only 4 hours. So, well, it's expensive to do it in the A100, but it's really faster in comparison. You will understand later why, because, well, I use a parameter which allow the PyTorch Lightning to find the optimal batch size, and then if you take and this is obviously looking at the amount of the available memory that you have in your GPU, and if you have a GPU like a T4 with 16 gigabytes, you have less memory than available for batches, for data, than the memory that you have available with a 100, which have 40 gigabytes of memory, as you can see on the screen. Okay, so here we just load the dataset, multi-news, again here train, validation test, total 55,000, here you have the number, here you have an example, this is the document, they are relatively long documents, yeah, 6,217 characters, and here the summary, 1268. In average, you will see now how I do the tokenizer. But yeah, well, this is approximately 1000, 1024, a little bit more tokens. It's gonna do a truncation if the length is bigger than that. And for summaries, approximately, it's gonna be kind of the yeah. Make a you can make a very simple count formula to calculate what means tokens versus length of the test. Is practically 5. Make an average of 5, maximum 5 characters per token, and you will see approximately a text of 5,500 characters is gonna be together with the prompt. No, you see that the prompt here is very small, but approximately 5,000, between 5,000 and 5,500 tokens is 1,024 tokens, which is the input of the T5, and then on I'm doing an output of 256, which is a little bit bigger. But well, I also allow the how to say, to create a little bit longer summaries. To later on have a little bit probably more rich text to later on do this a better summary. The idea here, this is going to be a component again which is working in a pipeline, and this is this model had the objective to later on summarize very big documents with hundreds of pages or even more, and then make a summary of the document and prepare a summary which represent the document, the whole document, and later on compare with the description of the categories of some classes. But well, this topic, I will cover this topic in the next video, where I how to say, create the final pipeline with all the components, where I using LangChain as well, and this is only related to the fine-tuning of the model using the using a specialized data set in document summarization. So we create the so example again, random example. So the length of the this is the so in document you have the original document, the input, and here in summary you have the summarization, again done by a professional. I take a Flantified tokenizer. I pass all the data set through the tokenizer, and now I prepare the trainer and train the model. We need this specific class as well, the same that you cannot use all the architectures or models available in Hugging Face. We need to use specific classes to train to do this training. It's a sequence to sequence, and for this there is a specific classes: sequence to sequence LLM, sequence to sequence training arguments, and sequence to sequence trainer. I load the model with BrainFloat 16, which is possible with a T5. That was another reason to take a T5. My method or my function to count the parameters, just here a tag for later on serialize the No, sorry, this is only for the logs. And then I create my training arguments. This is the argument I mentioned before, auto find batch size. This Python's Lightning will find the optimal batch size looking at the memory that you have available. A little bit high learning rate in comparison with other problems or other tasks or other cases or other examples I did. Non-train epochs 10, epochs 10 exactly. Login to the temporary location on drive. Logging every 500 steps, evaluation every at the end of every epoch, only set maximum two checkpoints, the two better checkpoints, and the load at the end of the training, load the best model in memory. Report to 1DB as usual with unbiases. And here I just calculate the number of parameters using the function I defined before, 248 million parameters. It's a very small model in comparison with others. Data collator as well, for sequence to sequence, it had to be specific, special for that. Cleaning the memory, creating the trainer, model, arguments, train dataset, test dataset, and data collector, and training. The training in my case took again approximately 4 hours, 12 minutes, 10 epochs. Well, again, if you want to use a T4, it's possible. You have the memory available on the GPU, but it's gonna take. That's why I changed it to the E100. I think it was 53 hours, and then it's too much. I pushed the model to Hugging Face for others to have others have the possibility to use it if they want. You have it here. I will try to improve as well how this model cars, just to explain exactly better. Well, how I did the training, that well, this probably for the next video where I do a fine tuning, because I still didn't have time, a lot of time to read how to do this. Here is pretty nice how they make this with a simple command. Does create the space also with the inference API. It's really 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 good how the Hugging Face is doing this. I also serialized to this and log the model in the model repository in weight and biases. And here I make the inference. I just a text. I download the model from weight and biases. The model I just upload here moments ago. So using well, I think I commented some videos, but well, in weight and bias, this login and reporting tool very similar to MLflow. The specializing in training LLMs, it's a commercial tool. Well, at the end, it's working very similar. You just create a run. You point to the model in your model repository. For those that are working with MLflow, you will see that this nomenclature is very similar. And you download with this. You download this. Essentially, is downloading the model from the model repository. And here is it returns the path in. It's a temporary path, as you can see here. Where is the model that you serialize or you upload before to weight and biases? Import the pipeline. You create a summarization pipeline. Pass the model, fine-tune model, and tokenizer. And as you can see here, response. You get a list of responses so that you can send it in batches. You can do inference in as you may know, in using the pipeline, you can use batches of the a size that you can determine. Here I'm just doing for one element, just to do a test. I didn't do it in batches, it's just one element, but the response again is going to be a list of the predictions, and in they put the prediction in this is a summarization activity in the attribute summarize text, and then you see here this is the summarization that was done by the fine-tuned model, and this is the summarization done by the flantified original model. So I make here just a comparison of the answer. The text was 448 characters. This that was the summarization. It's very big. what the summarization that is done by the fine-tuned model, and this is the summarization done by the Flantified. And here I just take the rows, I load the metric, and I take 100 documents here. It crashed, but in a try I did before. So you just take with just 10 elements. You have here a description, a very good document I found in Medium from a guy who explained very well how it works. This metric is very interesting. If you are interested, you can just follow the link and read how it works. But well, you when you compute the metric here, just with 10 examples, this is what Flantified without training, without fine-tuning, produce. Is not bad, to be honest. It's a not bad metric, but you can see here that the fine-tuning model is better, is getting even better metrics. And that's all. I will take a look now why it's, yeah, it's probably some parameters I need to investigate as well, how to do this a little bit more optimized. But again, something to tell you as well, you can take a look here with 100 examples. So every example, taking one by one, and in the CPU is taking 47 seconds. And I think that even in this case, which using the A100, the server is crashing because of the process is consuming all the RAM available. I need to investigate this, but well, this is not a question that impact on the final analysis, no? I think that we evaluate the whole data set, we are going to get metrics similar, really similar to this. It's just an example, but as you can see, we improved the metrics with the fine tune, and then now we have a model, a small model that is going well. It's probably not perfect, but and we can get probably better outputs, for example, with a Mistral. But we have to consider that this is very small model, and we cannot make miracles with this, no? But for the purpose I'm gonna use, and you will understand this on this in the second video, in the second part of these videos, where I create a pipeline and what is the reason to do it this way, because I need to. It's a practically I can anticipate you. It's part of a bigger component, and I don't want to introduce additional delays just because an additional complexity using different models than the models I'm using in the classifier, and also introduce the complexity of the and the causing infrastructure to have it to use a another model, another series, and also a bigger model. And that's all. Hope you like it, and if you like it, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much, and see you soon.